15th year. The national average is 1 year that house parents continue in a home setting like King's Home. That's the special call that God has on Scott and Kim's life and on their hearts to share with so many boys for 15 years. Scott and Kim, thank you for sharing for a couple of minutes.
Hey, so as Lou said, we've been here almost 15 years, and during that time, we've had close to 150 boys that have lived with us, six or seven at a time. We basically are mom and dad and do everything that mom and dad do for their kids. We have kids, every kid that comes has a different story. It's our job to teach them some things that they don't know, help them get caught up in school. And it is our privilege and our honor to be used by God in their lives. And ultimately, we try our best to model what a Christian family looks like for these kids.
Morgan, do you think it's tougher to be family teaching parents, or you think it's harder to be a young person? What do you think, Morgan? We'll hear directly from you. Y'all welcome Morgan.
Good evening, my name is Morgan Shaw, and I would like to share my experience at the King's Home. When I arrived at the King's Home, I was placed in a Hodges home where the Thomases are the house parents. I was placed here because I had behavioral problems such as fighting and being disrespectful to staff. I needed to be at a place to work on my behavior. Mr. Marquez, Ms. Chris, and Ms. Marquita helped me through a struggle. Because when I came, I had to get used to a new environment, new people, and learn different routes. I learned to accept feedback on accepting no and how to control my emotions. I had a problem with becoming angry easily. I also became more open with sharing my feelings with others. I have learned positive behaviors such as saying okay and not arguing back with staff, and choosing appropriate words to say, such as saying words that don't offend other people. I managed these skills so that it would help me better myself in life. I advanced levels and was encouraged to do right. I was also encouraged to pursue my goals of attending college. I have more confidence that my future will be brighter. I'm very appreciative of what the King's Home has done for me. I hope the other youth utilize the skills taught to improve themselves to prepare for life.
Great job, Morgan. Oh, that's awesome. Dana, thank you for taking a minute to share your heart, too. Appreciate so much you being here with us. So, y'all, welcome, Dana.
Hey y'all, I'm Dana. I am 26 years old. I am a single mother, and I've been married twice. I am one of the many faces of domestic violence, whether it be men or women. My story started when I was in fourth grade when my mom left my dad. They had been married for roughly 18 years. I witnessed my dad controlling my mother, saying ugly things to her, you know, telling her a variety of different things that no child could ever see their parents do to each other. I finally watched her walk away, and I chose to leave with her. We almost got run over by a Bronco. He chased us down when we moved to Houston, and he had her almost arrested. To go through that in fourth grade is a traumatizing thing. You would never think, oh, well, you know, you'll get over it, but you don't, and it follows you throughout your life. When I got older, I got married, and unfortunately, my communication skills were not that great, and my marriage didn't end. I found my best friend that I knew for 5.5 years, and I thought he was the best man that I could ever meet. He was such a big man as far as the world. So we got married after knowing each other for 5.5 years. He had gone through a lot. He's a soldier. He watched his best friend have his arm blown off and a variety of different things. He had PTSD. When we moved in together after his deployment, his second tour of Iraq, he held me up against the door by my throat. I was wrestled to the ground by him. I was called a variety of different words that no woman should ever be called. And all of this was in front of a 4-year-old child. no child could ever see this. And I was sorry to have my son go through the same thing I had to go through when I was a kid. I came here after staying with my husband for a year, and I stayed at the King's Home since July. They've not only taught me to respect elders, they've taught me better communication, I've gotten great counseling, they've helped my child, and they've made a huge difference. And I'm so thankful because I'm closer to God and I'm so much better off. So thank you so much.
Dana, Scott, and Kim. Morgan left the stage. Oh, thank you so much. What an honor to be a part of a team to see God at work and seeing God transform lives. Thank you for what God's doing in your life. Thank you for what God's doing in your life. Morgan, you did a great job. Thank you so much for what God's doing in your life. Appreciate it so much, guys. All right, Randy Howell. Randy Howell's in the house. We're going to bring up a table with two barrels. Randy, have you had fun today?
We have had a ball today. It has been the most awesome campfire for the King we've ever had, man. We're fired up. Y'all fired up out there in the cold tonight?
Hey, Randy, I'm fired up too. Who's this big guy you got next to you? This big, good-looking athlete you got here. Who's that?
Yeah, this guy. This is a big baseball buddy of mine. This is Jason Stanger. Jason's played in Major League for how many years have you played overall now?
I just finished my 16th year.
16 years, Jason, man. Jason.
He doesn't look old enough to be pitching professional baseball for 16 years.
He went right out of high school into baseball like I did right out of high school into fishing.
Local baseball great Jason Stanger from Trustville, Alabama.
Yeah, Jason's playing full-time in Japan now, and he came home a couple weeks ago, and I called him just out of the blue today. I said, Jason, you want to come out and help out at Campfire for the King? He's got a big heart for kids and people. Great guy. He loves the Lord. Got a great testimony. I'll let him say a few words while I get this together here.
Hey, thank you all for having me tonight. This has been great. Me and my little boy are here, and he's been down. We've been down there doing the jumpy house thing for probably the past 3 hours. So I haven't even left there. But anyways, really am very, very thankful for Lou and Randy to have me here. And just wanted to tell y'all that, let's get a winner on this boat.
All right.
We got first real quick before we do the boat draw right now for all you guys out in the crowd way back in here. We've got my buddy Tom Lee of Grand True Image Promotions here tonight out from Oregon, and he is video and live streaming all my fishing fans all over the world watching right now and bought these tickets for the boat, and we're getting ready to draw for it in just a little bit. So bear with me a minute.
But we
had a big fish rodeo today out on the lake here at King's Home, and that's the most exciting part. We had over 100 kids out here fishing today. We had over 60 high school fishing teams present today from around 5 different high school teams helping the kids. Fun day. We got some prizes because Mark's Outdoors donated a ton of rods and reels from Daiwa and a lot of other companies. And we've got kids waiting here in line here that want to get a gift card tonight. The big fish for the 12 and under. For a girl and a boy, and then big fish for 13 and up for a girl and a boy. Get a $25 gift card to Mark's Outdoors. Go spend some money on some fishing stuff or hunting stuff. So let's call that out real quick, and then we'll do the boat. Ready?
And then we got two free drawings we're going to draw for right after that.
Two free drawings right after that. Okay. All right, first, the winner on the female today, and actually she caught the biggest bass out of the whole event, old and young today. And it was just a hair, just a little bit under a pound. We didn't catch any big ones today, unfortunately. But it was Nikki Strickland. Nikki, you still out here?
Way to go, Nikki!
Come on, Nikki, you out there? I bet Nikki got cold and left like some of the other fans out tonight.
That's
they're
right.
Freezing. We're chattering out here tonight. Alabama shouldn't be this cold tonight.
Hey, but it was 65 on the lake earlier today.
Yeah, it's perfect. All right, we'll give Nikki her gift card later. All right, next, Eli Bennett. Eli?
Go, Eli!
The winner. Here's Eli. We give Eli his $25 gift card right here. Eli's been waiting for that for a long time. Good job, Eli. All right, now, next one is the older group, female. How about Cheyenne McDaniel? Cheyenne, you out there? She out there? She's coming? You better run, Cheyenne. Where you at? Did I say your name right? She left? All right, doggone it. We got her $25 gift card. Y'all tell her she's around. All right, this other one now might need help on this one because Lamonte, is that you right there? Monte, did you catch a big brim? You're going to get $25 for that, man. Come on.
Big old back car. Is that a big old bluegill?
He caught a big brim today. Yep. He won the 13 and up. Thank you, Lamont.
All right, Jason. Now it's your turn. We got two free drawings. You could register when you came in. For the first one is a $250 gift certificate to Brookwood Mall. We're going to pull it out of this one right here, Jason. Who's going to be the winner? Draw it out for us.
Yeah, Jason, the mic. The boat team.
Where's that drum roll when you need it?
Drum roll.
Matt Murillo. All right, Matt. And for the motorcycle over there in front of Randy's boat, let's lock it up one more time. We'll roll it again one more time. Can we do it? There we go. Jason can do it. All right. For the motorcycle. Who wants that motorcycle?
I do.
Kenneth Bowling. Kenneth Bowling.
Oh, come on.
Kenneth in the house. We'll contact Kenneth.
Oh, there he is.
All right. He is here. That's top. All right. Way to go, Kenneth. You got your motorcycle. Compliments. Of Po Boys Wheel Source right here in Birmingham, Alabama. Alright, we'll shut this barrel up. Okay, Randy.
Alright, now what everybody's been waiting for, the $70,000 Triton Mercury fully loaded bass boat. People all over the country have donated to King's Home. We hit a new record. We sold 960 $100 tickets. That means we raised $96,000 for King's Home. All of us. That's right. God is good, man, and we proved it with that boat. Who would have ever thought that a bass boat could help raise that much money for such a great bunch of people here at King's Home and all the kids and women and children and everything. We're just blessed and thankful to do it. And everybody's waiting, so we're not going to make you wait any longer. This is all the boat tickets right here. It's been accounted for. Accountant come in from LSU. Unfortunately, not Alabama.
Where?
Yeah, LSU. He came in because he's a friend of mine, and he didn't charge me anything. That's why he came from LSU. But he came out. He did all the accounting on everything today, made sure all the tickets.
So what you're saying, man, it has been audited, right?
It has been audited. Yeah, everything's been audited. All 960 of them are in here. And I've got all the list of it right here.
So right, where's that drum roll?
Drum roll. I'm gonna let Jason do it. That way my hand's not pulling it out of there.
All right, Jason, it's all yours.
And then you hand it to me, and we're gonna take it right here in front of the camera so everybody can see it. Dig on there, and they're good. Come on, it's a big deal.
Oh, Jason's digging deep.
On,
He's
baby.
Digging deep. There you go, $70,000 Mercury Triton bass boat, and the winner is.
Here we go. Oh my goodness. Ready?
You must know this winner.
I don't, but his name is Nathan Stephen from Montgomery, Alabama. There it is right there. Nathan Stephen from Montgomery, Alabama. If you are watching online right now, I bet you're going to the bathroom first, and then you better have your phone ready because we're going to call you right now. Let's call him right now. You want to call him?
We're going to call him. Right? We're streaming live, and we're going to call him right now. Let's do it, Randy. All right, here we go. Nathan Stephen in Montgomery, Alabama is the winner of Randy's $70,000 bass boat. We're getting him on the phone right now.
If he hollers. I would be hollering. Wouldn't you be hollering? Huh? Come on, man. You better answer your phone, bro. He's caller ID-ing us right now. Hello? Hey, Nathan. Hey, this is Randy Howell. You know what you just won? You're on the speakerphone at King's Home, and you just won the Triton Mercury boat by donating to King's Home. What do you think? No, I'm serious, man. For all the people. Yeah, how about that? Is that all right? We're not really joking, though. We're serious, all right? Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm excited.
Awesome. I'm glad you answered the phone. Last year, the guy that won didn't answer his phone, but he called back real quick. So, all right, man. Congratulations. We're going to, where'd you buy your ticket at? All right, awesome. Saw it on Bassmaster.com. We want to thank all of the people everywhere on the websites, Bassmaster, all the bass fishing websites all over the country that put it up for it so these guys would know about it. We raised money. We sold 960 tickets, raised $96,000 for King's Home. So we appreciate all you guys everywhere watching right now that donated. And, hey, I'll get back in touch with you later tonight. Just hang on here in about an hour. I'll call you back, give you some more details, all right? All right, thank you, buddy. God bless. Bye. All right, that's it. He was excited. We're going to get to do it again next year. Next year. We're not going to think about it for a while, but next year we're going to do it again. Our goal was 1,000 tickets. Last year we sold 922. This year we sold 960. So we got to do it again till we hit 1,000 tickets because I'm a goal man. I got to hit my goal. I didn't get 1,000, but we got close. So thank all you guys for doing it. Lou,
God bless Campfire awesome. For the King. Thank you
Jason,
so much for
coming out.
Jason Spender, our celebrity man who drew the winning ticket. Randy, thank you for your
awesome.
Heart. I tell
that
you,
is awesome, man. That was fun.
I tell you, Randy Howell has a heart big as a mountain. Jason does too. Appreciate you guys being here tonight. Randy, thank you for what you do for King's Home.
It's awesome.
Is a great partnership
yeah.
to reach out to. You know, last year we sold to 43 states and 2 foreign countries. I know Canada had. We sold 2 to Canada this year.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I bet you reached out to 40-plus states again.
Yeah, I think it was 44 states when they were doing the thing earlier.
Exactly.
In a couple of 2 countries. So.
Been not a lot of fun. A
lot of people all over the country know about King's Home, and thanks for all the donations you did, and we're going to do it again next year, and God bless all of you. Appreciate it.
Nice good night.
Woo! Night.
Hey, Mr. Randy.
Awesome.
Thanks everybody for watching. We got a new boat owner in Birmingham.